about my sometimes pessimistic worldview than reality itself. So keep that in mind.
That should be your title.
Yeah, working on it.
Colon.
Okay. You can have it all, but you can't have it all at once. She is my lit teacher, a formative feminist influence, and her words ring with the wisdom of 35 years of teaching teenage kids hungry for and scared to death of their huge futures. You can have it all. The doors are there, she's telling me. Every door I want to enter, every achievement and position, power and prestige, if only I dare open them. But you can't have it all at once. The catch. Here are all the doors, a line of doors extending miles, their paint blue and brown and glossy, and if I open one door, hear the creak of its protesting hinges, a deadbolt down the line slides shut. The more knockers I lift, the more boards get nailed against the jams of all the other doors. I am a somewhat unstable teenage girl who likes poetry, and like most unstable girls with loves of poetry, I like Sylvia Plath. I read The Bell Jar in 10th grade and thought she'd written it for me. The older I get, the more solipsistic I become in that regard. She writes of towering fig tree, branches heavy with fruit. Each fig symbolizes some fantastic future ahead. One is a happy family, another the life of a famous poet, another a position as a brilliant professor, an editor, foreign lovers with foreign names, travel. If you choose one fig, clamber up the trunk to a single branch and pick one fig. Pluck your forbidden fruit of choice. The rest fall and rot in the dirt, their possibilities lost to you. No take-backs if you pick the wrong fig. Store policy is no returns. So instead of inching up the tree, instead of pursuing your fig with all your vigor, you stand at the base, paralyzed with fear. Rather than choose the wrong one, or choose one at all, you abstain from fig picking completely. The fruit drops before ever touching your fingers, and the tree withers away, felled by your fatal uncertainty. You can have it all, but I know I can't. I know that having one thing means losing another, and nobody believes any different. I know it because when I wanted to be a doctor, people told me I wouldn't be a doctor. They said I'd get married instead. I know it because when I told my dad I wanted to be a journalist, he said I couldn't do what I love and not starve to death. How can you choose when every choice is equally attractive and repulsive to you? I want baby blankets and sticky fingers, and I want lullabies and forced piano lessons. I want the joy I can have when I make something out of my own body and blood. And I want pantsuits, and I want a professional position, and I want glossy photos and block typeface. I want red pens and people to answer to me. And I want conflict and war. I want tears and shrapnel. I want to talk to refugees in dirty desert camps, and I want to cover rebel soldiers in clandestine locations. I want to be captured and held for a ransom. No one will pay for a lowly war correspondent. And I want long Saturdays shut up with a keyboard in a shaded office on my home second floor. And I want the smell of Sharpie and my signature on a page. And I want my name on a dozen front covers in glossy script. And I want a doctor before my name, and name written upon a chalkboard every fall. And I want to teach impressionable college students to do something bigger than themselves. And I want to spend my whole life cramming my brain with knowledge. And I want to learn how to play upright bass and join an indie band. I want to tour the country playing music I make to audiences who don't give a damn what our clever band name is. And I want to run a girls' orphanage in Peru. I want to mug with 50 girls and make sure they have bras and tampons and lunches and all the things I've never had to ask for. And I want to own a small bookstore. I want to buy secondhand paperbacks with pen in the margins. I want to recline on a leather chair all day reading Aristotle and Austin and Poe. And I want to live in Buenos Aires. I want to live in Spain. I want to live by dirty canals and hear song in 100 languages. I want to live in a jungle or savanna. I want to live somewhere where for the first time in my life I can get a tan. I want to climb to the top of the world and see what I can see from up there. And I want everything, but I can't have everything. The tree is so vast and I am such a slow climber. I can't have it all, and I definitely can't have it all at once.